To defend the right to protest is by protesting, which is why on November the 21st at the next National Student Demo, which is fully supported by the UCU, and we will be mobilizing our members to be on there with you, it's important we make it as big as possible. We will not allow politicians or the police to intimidate us off the streets.
We're here to support our friends Alfie Meadows and his family. We're in complete solidarity with him, and we demand that Alfie go free. We demand that the police are charged for illegally battening him over the head. Is that not illegal? I want to ask every police officer here today, are you trained in Hendon to batten civilians over their heads? Is that not a completely dangerous thing, a life-threatening thing to do? In 1995, Brian Douglas met his fate on the high street of Clapham after being banged over the head by police officers using the brand new American style batons. It's as if they wanted to try it out that day. They then dragged him into a police van, took him to a police station and left him in a cell dying, yeah, for many, 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 many hours. I didn't want to get the amount of hours wrong. I think it was over 7 hours he was left. And that man died. This was in 1995. He was killed by a baton and a blow over the head. And I know for a fact that police are not trained to do that, and it's illegal to do that. So why the hell did you do that to Alfie Meadows? Did you not learn any lessons from Brian Douglas' death? And the shame of that death was that the officers, Sergeant Puffy, was a racist, and he was proven to have done many assaults on people previously and since, and he walked scot-free out of court. Now that family have never forgotten what happened to their brother that fateful day. And they've been campaigning ever since, and out of that family fight came the United Family and Friends campaign. And Alfie and his family have joined up with the UFFC, okay, to support other people and families that have been murdered in police custody, and that could have been Alfie's fate. His mother could have buried him, could have had to bury her child, her son, her only one of her, sorry, she has two sons. She would have had to bury, was it your youngest son? She would have had to bury her first child. She would have been burying her first child. How dare the police put this family through that and now further attack them by taking him to court for violent disorder. The police are the ones that should be being charged with violent disorder. This is fact. So we're here in solidarity to say we demand that Alfie Meadows walks free so that he can then choose his legal right to take the police to court for illegally banging him over the head and causing him to have emergency. And this officer, I don't like his attitude because he's smirking and it's really annoying. He's smirking. Listen, my brother died on a concrete floor of Brixton Police Station, not in a cell, outside at officer's feet. It's very painful to stand here, okay, in front of officers and there's a smirk on his face. And I'm not being disrespectful. I'm telling you the truth. It's very disheartening. Very, very disheartening after you've lost someone in this way to be confronted by police like this. It's not fair. It's not fair. Okay, so anyway, we will fight to the hilt to make sure that Alpha gets justice. This is insane and it's not right. And we will support him all the way.